Louisa.
Yes, madam. I have a special guest tonight, so I want you to prepare a dinner for two in the garden. I want it with scented candles, fresh flowers, and chilled wine. Okay?
Yes, madam.
And will you be needing me to stay tonight?
Oh, I won't. In fact, when you're done, you can go home.
Thank you, madam. And you can come in the afternoon tomorrow. It's okay.
Thank you, madam.
Louisa!
Mother.
Are you on your way home?
Yes, Mother, because Mimi sent me home early to make up for all the things she had me do yesterday.
Louisa, I would...
What is it, Mother?
I want to apologize to you.
Huh? Why? For what, Mother?
Well, because I've been suspicious of you. That night when your father and I went to pick you up for Mimi's, I thought you were out with Cardine. And then this morning, over breakfast, I heard Menang say she saw Cardine in his car with some girl last night. I thought that confirmed my suspicion. I'm sure Menang thought the same thing.
Mother, I have...
It was a good thing. Mimi arrived and she explained everything. It was her in the car with Cardine last night. Louisa, I'm really sorry. I should have taken your word for it. I shouldn't have doubted you. Bipping.
Mother, I found a coin lying around outside, so I dropped it in the money jar.
Wow, what a thoughtful thing to do. Are you home alone?
Present! I didn't go out as you expected. I stayed home.
Oh, will you stop that already, Nana? You sound like a broken record.
Okay, as long as you stop using that line too. It's so old, you're the only one who uses it.
What does sound like a broken record mean?
Shh,
did you return the bag?
Oh, yes.
That's good. Go on, set the table
for
dinner.
Come on, Pippin.
Louisa, give her a hand, okay?
Yes, Mother.
Mother!
Hi.
I'd like you to meet our new neighbor. His name is Diego.
Hi.
And he needs something repaired, Mother.
Sure, what is it, Diego?
Here it is. And I brought some rice cakes to thank you for all your help.
That's really nice of you, Diego. You shouldn't have bothered. Why don't you have dinner with us while I go fix this? Louisa, please set another place for Diego.
Yes,
although
Mother.
We are having fish tonight, do you eat fish?
Oh, yes, I do, madam.
Have a seat. I'll just repair this.
Your first payment is due on the 15th. You can deposit it straight to my account.
Payment?
Have you forgotten, madam? You're supposed to pay 15% interest on the 2 million. Every 15 days in the month.
No, I haven't forgotten. 15%. 300,000?
Is there a problem?
No.
Menang, I can see right through you. Your finances are a problem. I told you, 2 million is easily spent. So why don't you take my advice? Run for mayor.
Why do you want me to get into politics? What are you going to get out of it?
Nothing. Little favors, maybe. Permits. Contracts. You know how business is, right? Give and take.
I don't know. I'm afraid that I might be in over my head if I do that. I don't want to complicate my life.
It's your choice. But allow me to remind you that if you do not pay your debt, in 3 months, your house will be mine. So I'll see you in 15 days. I don't think so. I think women are more complicated. I can't figure out what you're thinking or feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Women are mysterious.
You know, it all depends on the woman. If you choose me, you won't have a hard time. Because you know too well exactly how I think. I'm just kidding. Lighten up.
Of course. I know it's a joke. Maybe women are afraid of getting hurt. And that's why they try to hide their feelings. That is, until they're positively sure of how the man feels. We should initiate everything, right?
Initiate? Initiate what?
To express what we feel inside. I think it's about time I tell Luisa.
What's there to tell, huh? She knows she's your best friend. I'm sure of it, Cardin.
But that's not all I feel, Mimi. She's not only a best friend. Luisa's more than that. I love Luisa. I'm in love with her. Luisa is the only girl for me. Only her. I think I'm drunk. I am not usually like this. I'm sorry. I better go home.
Don't leave yet, Cardin.
What?
Stay a bit longer.
It's so late, okay? And you better rest, okay? Later. See you later.
I was only 15 years old when our parents died. And since then, I've been taking care of my sister, Jojo.
What about your other relatives? Don't they help you out?
Well, I guess they couldn't. They have families of their own.
And so what? You were only kids then, and they turned your backs on you?
That's okay, I guess. Our lives didn't turn out all too bad. Yes, it was difficult at first, but thankfully we got through it.
And where is your sister?
Oh, you mean Jojo? She's coming over sometime next week. She's just completing the document she needs to study over here. She's graduating high school.
Totoy, Jojo's your age. Maybe the two of you can be friends.
Oh, sure. Do you like basketball? Because Jojo loves playing basketball.
Basketball? I don't get to play all too often. Only when I get time off work.
Oh, just like Jojo. You're both industrious. That's why I work so hard so she can finish her studies. If I can do that, at least one of us will have a degree.
Todoy? More water from the well, please.
Oh, let me do it. I don't mind.
Luisa, please show Diego where the well is.
Oh, no, it's all right. I know where it is.
I'll go with him. I need to check on something.
Such a nice boy. Hardworking and kind, too.
You're right. Did you hear what he said? He started taking care of his sister at such a young age. And you know what else I like about him?
What?
It's as if he's not interested in Luisa. He even went to the well alone, remember? That's the kind of friend I want for our kids. Someone we can trust.
You're leaving again?
Yes. I'm going out with Mimi.
That's nice. You know, I approve of this completely. Why don't you court her? She's a good match for you. She's beautiful, smart, sophisticated, and most of all, she's rich, just like us. It's a match made in heaven.
I'll think about it. Okay, I have to go.
Okay, bye.
Thank you for getting that interview for me.
That's good to hear. Well, congratulations.
Tatoy.
So when...
Diego.
Luisa, guess what? Diego was able to get a job, and he's going to help me get in, too.
Oh, that's good. Now you don't have to take on those odd jobs anymore.
I have an idea. Why don't you come with me today? I'll introduce you to my boss.
Okay, okay. Let me just change. I'll be right back.
Okay. Diego, can you look after my brother? He has asthma. In fact, Totoy just had a really bad attack last week, and he's still recovering.
Don't worry. I'll take care of him.
Thank you.
So, what do you do?
Cleaning, helping my mother out.
Oh. Well, Totoy is a good worker, isn't he?
Of course. You won't regret it.
Oh, that's good.
Wake up, Mimi. Rise and shine.
What is wrong with you? Will you please close the curtains? It's too bright.
Oh, my gosh, Mimi. What did you drink last night? And look at you. You look like a mess.
Oh, shut up, will you? Get out, both of you. Leave my room. Just leave me alone.
What is it?
Will you get
up? What's the problem?
Get
up. Come on.
Come on. What's happening to you, huh?
What happened?
I hate her. He is going to propose to that woman. I just cannot believe that. He's going to tell that he loves that woman, that laundry woman. I can't believe that he chose that pathetic woman, that no good servant, over me. Over me. He's so stupid.
Hey, it's okay. Oh, my. So, what now? Hey. Now, wait a second, Mimi. Don't tell me you're giving up. Come on. Will you stop and think, Mimi? You can still beat her. Luisa is nothing compared to you.
That's right, Mimi. They trust you. You can manipulate Carding, Madame Menang, and more importantly, Madame Idad. That's a big advantage.
Madam Mimi?
Oh. I would just like to inform you Carding is waiting for you outside.
Hi, Carding. I'm going for a swim. Would you like to join me?
Mimi, I need your help.
Is this about Luisa again?
Yes. I have decided to finally court her. But I think there's someone who beat me to it.
Who?
I don't know. He's new here, but I've seen him several times. I think he's courting her, Mimi. What should I do?
And why are you telling me all this?
Because I need your help. Tell Luisa to go to our train later. I'll propose to her there. Come on, Mimi, please. You're the only one who can convince her. Please, I need your help. I'm desperate. Please.
Sure.
Really?
We're friends, aren't we?
Awesome, thanks. You're the best. You're the best. Okay. Thank you. I'll see you later.
Louisa, you can stop now. Carding needs to talk to you. He says it's important. He's waiting for you inside your train.
Oh, I don't think I will.
Louisa, I'll make sure nobody knows. So it's safe for you to go there. If you don't go, Carding might wait for you all day.
Well, Madame Mimi, I'm sorry, but it's all up to him.
Louisa, I told you he said it's important. And I agree. That's why I quickly volunteered to help the both of you out. Go ahead, go meet him there. Give him a chance. Louisa, go on. Please do this. Go see Carding. Please, for my sake, I can't take it anymore. You know, Louisa, it's difficult being caught in the middle of all this. It's hard covering up for you and Carding with Madame Minang. I don't want to lie to people anymore.
Okay, then. I won't take long.
Saling!
Yes?
Are you busy?
I'm packing up because it's raining. Why?
I was wondering if you can come with me. I don't want to meet up with Carding alone.
Okay. Mother, I have to go with Louisa. Can you continue this for me?
Okay.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hurry.
Careful. Hey, Dad, it's been hours since I asked Louisa to buy some nail polish for me, and, well, it usually doesn't take this long. She hasn't returned, has she? Maybe you have her cell phone number so I can call her and ask where she is.
I don't, madam. Maybe she's on her way back.
She could be.
Excuse me.
Edad, wait! Have you seen Carding?
No, I haven't. Not since he left this morning. He told me he was going to meet you. He said the two of you were going out.
Is that what he said? But I was just at home. Oh, no, I'm so sorry. I think I just gave the two of them up. Oh, no, I really don't want any trouble, Edad. If it's all right with you, please don't tell anyone that I opened my big mouth. Please, Edad, I'm afraid Carding and Louisa might get mad at me. Carding?
Oh, hello.
What is it that you wanted to say? Can you make it quick so that me and Saling can hurry back?
Do you mind if we talk inside so that no one will hear us? Please?
Go on. I'll be fine out here.
Oh, by the way, this is for you.
Wow, for me? This is my favorite.
Really?
You're so sweet.
Okay. You enjoy that.
Oh, I will. I'll be waiting for the two
Careful.
Of you.
Fixed our train up. Have a seat. Louisa, there's something I need to tell you.
What is it?
Louisa, you've been asking why I've been acting this way. Now I will tell you the reason. I hope you don't get mad at me.
Well, girls, This is a big fight. Enjoy the show. What is it?
You're not going to get mad?
No.
Really?
Yes.
Promise me first.
I promise. Please hurry, Carding. What is it? My mother might go to Madame Carmen's house and find out I'm not there, so tell me.
Actually, I still don't know how I'm going to tell you. I've practiced and practiced. So, I'll just show you.
Luisa, your mother's here. Your mother, she's outside. What?
Luisa? Luisa, I know you're in there. Luisa, come out right now.
So what's taking this show so long? Anything happening already?
Dad just made her entrance. I'm sure she's giving it to Luisa right now.
Luisa!
Madam Edad, what's the matter?
Well, I just thought... Where's Luisa?
Oh, I'm sorry, I haven't seen her the whole day. I don't know.
I thought Luisa was here.
Do you want something to drink?
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
What's happening? Why is it so quiet? That and Dad should be dragging Luisa all the way home right now. What happened?
Come on, you can come up now.
Celine, come on, let's go home.
But Luisa, wait.
Carding, you always get me in so much trouble. I've had enough. Let's go now.
I'm sorry.
Celine, let's go.
Goodbye.
So how did it go? Did you meet up with Carding?
Yes.
So what happened? Come on, tell me about it. What did he say?
Nothing. I couldn't stay long and I had to leave. We didn't have a chance to really talk. Excuse me, I have to get back to work.
Oh, I had a chance to talk to your mother earlier. But I didn't say anything. I hope you and Carding didn't get caught.
Fortunately. No, we didn't get caught. Excuse me.
Will you hurry?
What's happening?
I don't know, but Madame Manning is having all the servants called. Hurry!
Well, you finally arrived. I couldn't start until every one of you was here.
I'm sorry, madam.
I have a big announcement to make. I have realized that it's just me and Carding who live in this house. And when school starts, Carding will not be here. So I won't be needing some of you anymore. Do you understand? I will let some of you go. You will get your salaries on the 15th. And for some of you, it will be your last.
Madam, how many of us will get to stay here?
Only two of you.
Oh, no.
Now go. Get back to work, all of you.
Don't worry, Mother.
I'll stop going to school first. I will try to look for a full-time job so that I can help with expenses here.
Me too, Mother.
And me too, Mother. Since I know how to cut hair and put makeup on people, I can apply for work in a parlor.
If there's anyone who should stop going to school, it's me. Mother, why don't we just use the money that we put in the money jar? I graduated from high school, right? I'm sure that I can find a decent job.
No one is going to stop school. Education is the only inheritance we can leave you. We won't allow you to stop going to school.
But Mother...
I am the head of this family. Let me find a solution to this.
Mother? What's wrong? I'm sorry about today, Mother. Mimi told me that you were looking for me. I was out on another errand for her.
I know, dear. And I'm so thankful that I raised you right.
You shouldn't say that, Mother.
What I'm saying is the truth, dear. It's you. You and all your siblings. You're the only treasure your father and I have. I'll make sure you finish school. Even if I have to beg, I will do it. If only to fulfill all your dreams, our family's dreams.
Thank you, Mother.
No. Luisa, we are the ones who should be thanking you. It's bad enough that we both don't earn much, and now I might even lose my job.
Leave everything to me.
Come on, Thomas. You've been saying that for almost 18 years, and has anything happened?
Dad, are you saying that I'm worthless?
No. No, that's not what I meant. Thomas, I'm just scared. Our dreams are slowly falling apart, and in time there'll be nothing left.
That will never happen, Edad. I promise.
Is your Madam Manang ready?
She's still dressing up. Please have a seat.
Okay, I'll just wait for her.
Okay, Madam.
Oh, Edad.
Madam?
How have you been?
Actually, I'm a bit worried. You see, Madam Menung told us that she doesn't need too many servants, that she might fire me.
Really?
Yes, Madam.
And what about your family?
That's what's been keeping me up at night. Madam Carmen, do you know anyone who is in need of a laundry woman? Or even just an extra hand in their house?
Not at the moment. But don't worry, Edad. I will ask my friends if they do.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate your help, Madam Carmen. Mm-hmm. I've bothered you enough. I better get going.
Oh, let me tell you, the time I spent at that spa was well worth it. I feel so recharged. Mimi, you should come with me next time, okay?
Mother, I want to study in the city.
Sure.
I want to live there too.
No problem. We have a lot of vacant units in our condominium now. Is there a particular school that you would like to enroll in?
Well, I want Karding School.
All the while I thought you wanted to take up interior design. And now all of a sudden you want to go to a business school? To think you're not even interested in business.
Let's just say I want to broaden my horizon. And think about it, Mother. Karding and I can help each other expand your businesses.
And cashing a check for $200,000? I still have money in my savings account. I'll transfer the funds.
Hey, Mother.
Hi.
Are you okay?
Yes.
I will need $80,000, Mother, so I can enroll.
Do you really need it today? Can't we pay the school in installments?
Of course not. Why? Is there a problem?
No, there's none.
Are you sure about that?
Yes.
You know I can transfer to a school with a lower tuition fee.
No. You're going to the same school your father and grandfather attended.
Okay. By the way, I was wondering if I could get an advance on my trust fund. It's just $50,000.
Where are you going to use it?
For my transportation expenses. And I'm going to get my car fixed.
Oh.
Okay?
Okay.
Mwah. Now don't stress yourself out, okay? Thank you, Mother. Mwah.
I love you.
Love you too.
David, we have to talk. Something has come up.
Guess who?
Please, Carding, I have a lot to do. I don't have time for your games.
Can we talk again? I haven't told you what I wanted to say.
Madame Carmen is back home. If she catches us talking, she'll tell your mother and my mother, too.
Well, then, let's just go out. I don't need much of your time. It will just take a minute.
Carding, I'll be honest. I don't want to. I feel so guilty doing this to my parents. Enough. I want to stop lying to them. So will you please just leave me alone?
Has the deadline passed for the filing of candidacy?
It hasn't. Why?
You're absolutely right. Money is easily spent. Before I spend it all, I'm going to accept your offer. I will run for public office.
Wise decision. Mayor Medell.
Hey, kid. Why are you crying, huh? Did you lose your way? Where's your mother? Do you know where your house is? Do you? Come on, I'll take you home. Stop crying. Hold on. Where are we going? Are you sure this is the way to your house? There are no more houses here. Huh? Hey, kid, where are you going? Come back here!
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
Carding! What is this again? Why did you have to use that child?
Shh. Allow me to talk first. I still haven't told you what I wanted to say.
So tell me now, Carding, and get this over with.
It's better if you just read it. You are not going to regret your decision to run for mayor. Like I told you, you are a sure winner.
What are we going to do? Well, David, if you must know, I helped a lot during my husband's campaign. That's why he won, because of me.
Oh, then this isn't going to be new to you. Well, we'll start tomorrow. We'll have to get everyone's attention to announce that you are going to run in the next election. We also need to clean up your image. The, people should see that you're a good person, that you're a loving mother, that you sincerely care for the poor, and most of all, the reputation of your family has to be really intact.
There's nothing to fear. I assure you, David, that we don't have anything to hide. My family's reputation is impeccable.
Good. So starting tomorrow, we will go to places where there are a lot of people. We'll go to markets, cooperatives, charity wards in hospitals, and orphanages. Banjo, prepare everything for tomorrow.
Right away, sir. I'll give them a call.
Wait a minute, David. Are you sure about this? Those places you just mentioned smell bad.
Menang, the smellier, the better. We will go to all the dirty places because there you will find the people who will make you win. Are you ready?
Fine. So what else should we do?
Well, I will be needing 500,000. We need to put up a headquarters, get computers, telephone lines, and we are going to hire your people. We need to have campaign shirts printed.
Okay, no problem. And how much will my 500,000 earn?
I tell you, Mana, more than you'll ever expect. Much, much more. This is all for you. Because of what you read a while ago. Aren't you going to say something? Don't worry. All of them are from the city. They don't care about us. My mother and your mother will never know.
I just don't know what to say. Cardine, you know this is not right.
Is it not right? Luisa, is it wrong to love?
But didn't we agree that you and I can only be friends? I thought you understood that.
I do. But I cannot help what I feel inside. I didn't mean to fall in love with my best friend.
Carding, I'm sorry. I just can't give you what you want. I don't want to. I just can't. I can't.
Luisa, don't I have any chance? Luisa. Luisa, I love you so much.
Cardine. I really need to go now.
Wait, Luisa. But you haven't answered me yet. Do I have a chance with you? Luisa, I'm leaving. I'm going to the city to study. I don't know when I'm coming back. Listen, I was hoping that before I left, I'd at least know how you feel. Please, Luisa, tell me the truth. Do you love me?
Sir, I would like to ask for a favor. Could you let me work an extra shift? A night shift would do.
All right. I have to ask Tony if he's taking a leave.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Thomas, you're taking an extra shift? What a hard worker. You've been putting in for overtime a lot this week. Can you be honest with us? Are you avoiding your wife or what?
Hey, can you stop with this? I happen to love my wife. This is out of an urgent need.
You have to hand it to this man.
Thomas, are you all right?
Hey, it's Thomas.
What's wrong?
Are you okay?
Water. I got some water. Someone call the doctor. Thomas.
Must be his heart.
Mr. Thomas, your blood pressure is unusually high.
I'm just a little overworked, that's all. I'm just a bit exhausted.
Please do not take this lightly. You aren't exactly young anymore. I think it would be better if you had yourself checked at the hospital.
Oh, never mind. They will not say anything different from what you did.
It is better to be certain.
Don't worry about me. I don't make a habit of neglecting myself. I should go so I can get some rest.
Mr. Thomas, do not take hypertension lightly. That symptom can one day turn into a heart ailment or stroke.